Hi DIYer, Joe here from Alarm Grid, and today we're going to talk about what wire should I use to power my Honeywell home security system. The best gauge wire to use for the system is actually an 18 gauge cable. If you go to our website, alarmgrid.com, and you search for a product that's called the LT-Cable, that's the best and most recommended cable to use if it makes sense for your install. We have one right here, and let's take a look at it. The LT-Cable. As you can see, it's a finished terminated power cable. On one end, we have finished spade leads that slip right underneath the transformer's screw terminals. And on the other end, there's a barrel connector that fits in to an attachment that has soldered tips. For example, on the Lyric system, that doesn't have a barrel connection. So you're actually going to have to use this adapter and then screw these little soldered tips underneath the screw terminals on the system to get this to power up. This is a really convenient cable because it's set, ready to go. You can just take it out, install it, and it's good to work. If you don't have an LT cable or you want to just use regular cable, over here, we have a piece of 18-4 cable. Typically, you want to use 18-2 as two conductors are all you need for the power connection. But if you only have four conductor wire, which has four pieces of wire in it, it's totally fine to use. You're just gonna use two conductors from it. So let's take a look at how to strip this. What we're gonna do is take our piece of cable and get a typical stripper. The first thing that you have to do is you have to remove the outer sheathing on it. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna score the outer sheathing just a bit. And then I found if you bend it and then pull it, if you get your score deep enough, it will break and you won't damage the cable. It's very important not to nick your cable when doing this because that'll make it weak and actually have it fail over time. As you can see, we have four wires in this cable. For convenience sake and because we're using power, we're just going to isolate the red and the black. You want to use the red on the hot or the plus. You want to use the black on the negative or the minus. As you can see, the wire actually has sheathing on it, so we're gonna have to strip that to get it to go under the terminal. The best way to do this is to take your stripper, lay it on the wire, and you just wanna apply enough pressure to score the sheath. When you feel it go down a bit, release the pressure and then pull with your finger, and it will slip nice and easy off the wire. It's important not to nick it, because when you go to bend it, you'll actually break the wire. So to see that again, we just take our stripper, we lay it on the wire, we apply a bit of pressure, release, and then slip right up and off. Now you have two pieces of cable that are ready to go. Let's go back to the LT cable though, as that's much easier to install on a transformer. Right here, we have the Lyric transformer. It's a DC transformer, and as you can see on the back of it, there's two screw terminals. If you look closely, there's a minus and a plus. The minus is the negative, the plus is the positive. It's very important to have your polarity correct when installing this transformer, because if it's incorrect on a DC device, it's going to blow it. You can't apply plus power to the negative terminal on the Lyric. On an AC system such as the Honeywell Vista, that doesn't matter. Polarity isn't important with that, and you really don't have to line up plus and minus. In fact, on that transformer, it doesn't even designate which one is the positive and which one is the negative. So if we pick up our LT cable, you'll notice that on this end, we have finished spade leads, and these can easily slip underneath the terminals and the clamps on the transformer. After you get one down, all you have to do is tighten it up. It's as easy as that. So if we take the other one, slip it under this clamp, tighten it up, and then you're good to go. All you have to do is plug this in the wall, attach this end on the Lyric screw terminals right on the back of it to plus and minus, and the system will power up. Either of the cables will work to power your system though, and they're both perfectly viable. That's pretty much the type of cable you want to use to power your Honeywell home alarm system. If you have any questions on this, feel free to send an email to support@alarmgrid.com. Also head over to our website, as we have lots of great information that you can check out on how to do this. Please, if you could, like and subscribe, and if you are interested, hit the notifications button and you'll get updated whenever we post a new video. Thanks for visiting and have a great day.